Hello friends and welcome to my YouTube channel. I am Dr. Danish Abbasi. Today we will be discussing about the myths and rumors of coronavirus. So as coronavirus spreads, so do all kinds of myths and rumors about COVID-19. Let's discuss and make sure that you are getting the right information. So the myth number one is that it's less dangerous than the flu. Because of its symptoms and spread, the new coronavirus SARS-CoV-2, which causes COVID-19, is being compared to the annual flu virus. Now, the WHO estimate that flu kills around 2,90,000 to 6,50,000 people each year worldwide. So, in terms of proportions, rather than number of deaths, COVID-19 seems to be deadlier than the annual flu. So, the only way we can compare I can say that one of the ways through which we can compare the fatal nature of COVID-19 with this annual flu virus is through the death rate. So the death rate as cited by the experts for COVID-19 is 1%, whereas for the annual flu virus is just 0.1%. Also, the coronavirus has a higher basic reproduction number. In other words, you can understand in this way that a person who is infected with this coronavirus, the ability of that person to infect others is quite higher in case of this coronavirus disease. The number that is being given for this is 2.2 cases compared to just 1.3 for flu. The concerning factor is that it's a new virus and we don't know yet how to treat it. Which medications might be effective in treating this, and also the long-term implications. And there isn't a vaccine yet available, even though there are thousands of cases of flu each year. A huge number of cases are prevented by flu vaccine. Scientists are working on to create a new vaccine for this COVID-19, but it will be months before it is out for public, available to the public. This is because of the rigorous testing vaccines have to go through to ensure its efficacy and also its side effects. So let's come to myth number two, which is you can catch it from pets. Even though the virus originated at a live animal market in Wuhan, it's pretty likely that our pets aren't contributing to the spread of the virus. According to the WHO, there has been no evidence about the household pets contributing to this disease. One case has been seen of a dog in Hong Kong testing weak positive for this coronavirus after its owner became infected with the coronavirus. Whilst the dog has been put under isolation, the authorities are still trying to understand the result. So you should always, however, wash your hands after touching your pets so as to reduce the the risk of contracting the E. coli and Salmonella. Now, the species responsible for the outbreak at the live animal market in Wuhan is yet to be confirmed, but suspects include pangolins, which are illegally traded for their meat and scales. Now, the SARS is thought to have originated from animal, the civet cats, before transferring to humans in the early part of this century. So, the myth number three includes face masks protect you from the virus. You might have noticed that more and more people are wearing this medical face mask in the last few weeks whilst out and about. So don't worry if you haven't bought any. The masks are fairly effective for an average person. Only people who are caring for the infected people and the infected people themselves need to wear these masks. Now some of the surgical masks which are quite popular among the people these days aren't effective because they are made to protect others from the wearer, not the other way around. So they likely won't prevent droplets reaching their mouth and nose. In fact, you may even increase your risk of contracting this the infection, as it's likely that you will be touching your face quite more. And shortages of masks caused by this panic buying of masks really puts health workers at risk if hospitals aren't able to get hold of them. Another myth is hand washing is ineffective. Claims have been made that hand washing is ineffective and it's trivial against the virus, that is absolutely incorrect. It is one of the very effective ways, and hand washing is one of the best disease prevention techniques we have. Learning the WHO 20 seconds hand washing technique will help you. Now always make sure to use a soap and warm water, and dry your hands using a disposable paper towel. If you don't have access to these, you can use a hand sanitizer in the meantime. Now the hand sanitizer containing 60% of alcohol are very effective in killing viruses and bacteria. Now it's also a good idea to clean any surfaces which you regularly come into contact with, for instance the door handles, the stair rails or the kitchen surface, etc. Now it's a way of preventing the infection. You can do all these things. I mean, it's quite effective. So now the another myth number five. There's nothing we can do to contain it. Although the number of cases have gone up, are going up, so is our understanding of how to prevent and treat it. Now restrictions on travel and closing of schools or banning the public gatherings are measures that will help contain the issue. Because quarantine is one of the effective ways we can contain the virus, because as I said earlier that we do not have any specific medication to treat it. Yes, oseltamivir is being prescribed to the patients, but we don't know any specific management or any specific treatment right now. So it's one of the best ways to restrict all these public gatherings and all, so as to prevent the spreading. Myth number six is that I am not at risk of getting infected with COVID-19. While some people will have milder symptoms, or some may not even have it, some may not even catch the virus at all, certain groups are at higher risk. Now, according to the study of 44% cases of COVID-19, those more likely to die from viruses include the elderly and those who are unwell or have weakened immune system. So basically it's like people who are in an immunocompromised states, like for instance people who are elderly, the elderly people have a weakened immune system, or people who are suffering from diabetes or hypertension or some chronic disease, or taking steroids because it is known to have it causes decrease in immunity. So it's all about the immune system, because if a person has weakened immune system, they are more likely, the chances of getting contracted with this virus is quite higher. And also the potentially men, it's seen that 2.8% of men died compared to just 1.7% of women. And also healthcare workers are at a higher risk because of daily basis being in contact with people having various diseases, and chances are likely that one of them might have contracted the coronavirus. So if you are not in any of these groups, that doesn't mean that you won't get it. You should still take measures like washing your hands and avoiding people who are unwell. So precautions, that's everything we can do right now, and I think precautions will really help us to fight this virus and contain. So right now we don't have any data about pregnant women at the moment, but if the COVID-19 affects pregnancy in the same way like the MERS and the SARS did, it's possible that we may have some fetal abnormalities and miscarriages. So that's all about for today. We'll bring up some more information to you soon. Stay safe and goodbye. If you like this video, then please share with your friends and colleagues. If you want to see more videos from this series, click on the box at the top. And if you want to see other videos, then click on the box at the bottom. And yes, don't forget to hit the subscribe button.